In this video, I'm going to talk about learning to write like a designer. Now, what do I mean by that? On the screen, I have a good example of what I consider the way that designers write. And this is taken from a blueprint that I have. And I'm just going to circle some lettering right in here. You'll notice that instead of calling it writing, I called it lettering, and that's sort of the traditional name and drafting terms for what we call the way that designers, architects, engineers often write. Most of them develop a really stylized way of writing on their sketches and notes that they make to each other. It's also a mark of professionalism that when you do make an engineering sketch or an architectural sketch, that it's easy to read your lettering and that it looks like you have a style that you practice. And so in looking at this lettering over here on the left-hand side, if I focus in on that for just a second, one of the things I notice is that everything is capitalized. So right off the bat, that's the first thing you can learn about lettering is capitalize everything. The second thing is if you look carefully at this, you can see that there are some light horizontal lines drawn, and those are called guidelines. And so in all this lettering, this drafter or architect went in first and drew some really light horizontal lines and then lettered between those lines. And I think that's important to also have guidelines. Another mark of a lot of lettering styles is that the letters are probably wider than they are tall. And so, you know, most of us don't letter that way. We probably letter where our letters are narrow. But one of the things I'm going to suggest that you do is that you widen your letters and make them wider than they are tall. You want to make the vertical strokes, like on the sides of this W or this L, these vertical strokes that are going up and down right there, make those consistently the same angle. And some folks even use a straight edge to make those things. They go that far. And I think you might start out using a straight edge, but eventually you'll get away from that because you'll get better at this. And other things to look for are similarities between letters. And like the top of the P and the top of the R are essentially the same stroke. Okay, so those are things to look for. You know, also apply these same techniques to numerals and numbers, that they should be wide. So we've got a 2 and a 1. Now the 1's not going to be wide, it's going to be a single stroke. Up here I can see we've got a 6, and we have a 4. We have some 3's over here. You can see sort of how those are created. And so I'm going to get into this. I'm going to show you an image. I actually have a camera set up on a little drafting table that I have, and this is a portable drafting table, and mounted on the table I have a parallel straight edge, and you can see that I have a box of what are called drafting dots. What these are these are tape dots, and these are used to attach a sheet of paper to the top of the drafting table. So what you want to do is align the top edge of the paper to the edge of the straight edge, the parallel straight edge right here, and then put a drafting dot in each corner. And if you don't have drafting dots, you can just tear off a piece of masking tape or other, actually there is drafting tape that's sold that comes in rolls, and you can just tear off a corner of that. So, but I'm using these things called drafting dots. Then, because the way I tape that down, I know that the edge of my paper is going to be parallel to the top and bottom edges of my parallel straight edge here. All right, so like I said, the first thing we want to do is draw guidelines. So I'm going to draw a couple of horizontal lines right along the top edge of my parallel straight edge. All right, and usually when we draw these guidelines, we draw them really lightly. We want them to basically be almost invisible. But I'm going to draw mine a little darker today for this video so that you can see what I have here. All right, now I'm going to show you how I was taught once you draw the guidelines, the architect who taught me how to write said, move your parallel straight edge up above your guidelines like this, and then take a small drafting triangle and put the triangle up against the bottom edge of your parallel straight edge, and move over here to the side. And then, and I'm going to switch over, I'm going to use a pen rather than a pencil. I think it'll be easier for you to see. He said, whenever you have a vertical stroke, like on the side of a B or an L or an E or a K or an F, an H, that you're going to make that with that vertical side of your triangle. Now, eventually you'll get to the point where that'll just become a way that you see things, and you'll stop. You don't even have to have the triangle. You'll just start, when you letter, you will just kind of learn to make things vertically as you letter your way across, right? And the other thing, like I was saying, you want your letters to be wide, okay? So I'm keeping my letters as wide as they are tall, or maybe a little bit wider. I want to show you something about this V. You see the angles that I used on that V? If I make an A, I want to use a similar angle as I use on the V. And if I make a Y, for example, I'm going to try to keep that angle the same. So what we're looking for are consistencies wherever we can get these things. So if I write the alphabet, you see how I make that C? It's sort of elliptical like that. That's because when I make an O, I make my O's like that. So when I make my C's, they look a lot like the O's. And if I make a Q, for example, it's just an O with the little vertical line on it like that. So if I come back to writing the alphabet, now watch the J. I get the width of the J down here on the bottom like that. And then I'm going to do a K, L, M, N, O, P, Q. Now, the top of the R and the top of the P should be very similar. And then you see this line we make on an R? If you come back to your K, that's the same line right there. So you realize after a while that this is really just a few strokes that you're making that you have to start making consistently. So I'll come back to my S and a T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z. Now, I want to show you something about my W. See how I use these two vertical strokes and I put the little V on here like that. But I want you to compare that to my M, and you'll see that I use two vertical strokes and a little V in the center. So my M and my W are just sort of an inverse of each other. Now, don't forget that you're going to need to write numerals, and we want to make those wide. Something like that right there. And the important thing is that you practice this over and over again until you get it down. So what we're trying to do is make our letters wide, make them consistent, make our vertical strokes where they're all the same angle. Now later on, as you learn this, you can start to stylize it. And I even noticed some in that example that I gave you a minute ago, that that drafter had made an F, something like that, where actually they came out of their guidelines. And so sometimes people get a real flair for things like that, and you know, and they'll add little things. They won't worry so much about staying inside their guidelines. I think that's probably something you would see more in architecture than you're going to see in engineering. Okay, so I'm going to draw some guidelines, and I'm going to write a sentence that you can use to practice because this sentence has every letter of the alphabet in it. So this is a good one to write. And the sentence goes like this. The quick brown fox jumps over the lazy, that's where we get the Z, red dog. You want to put an exclamation mark on it? That's great. Anyway, that's a sentence that you can write over and over again as you work on your alphabet. Where it doesn't help you is you don't get numerals in it. And of course, you're gonna be sketching a lot of numerals, so definitely want to practice those as well. All right, so I'm gonna draw some like taller letters, and this time what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add a third line. So I have a line here. That's the top line of my guidelines. There's the bottom line, and then I've got a center line. It's a little bit above center, and drawing those three lines like that gives you something to aim for when you're crossing your lines. And you can see that I'm kind of crossing all these letters at the same height when I use that, okay? And even when I make a P or an R or a K, I can bring that in there. So even though you can't really see it up here, I was sort of following that guideline, even to the point of where I cross my S there. I cross my threes up a little bit above center. You know, it's not, so this line is a little bit higher than being exactly halfway between my top and bottom line. All right, so I'm gonna come back real quickly to this slide here. So now that I've shown you some of the tricks, what I've done is I've written some of those down up here. Draw guidelines, capitalize the letters, make letters wider than they are tall, make letters approximately the same width, use a consistent angle for vertical stroke, make features shared by two or more letters consistent in shape and size. That would be like the tops of a P or an R, or the kickstand on a K or an R. And finally, practice. It'll, you know, take you a while to get good at doing this. But here's why you want to do it. Because when you're in an office and you're sketching with your colleagues and y'all are working on a design project, and everybody then gets together and compares their sketches and you're trying to show your ideas, if your lettering looks, if your lettering is hard to read, and if it looks like it did when you first learned to print in the second grade, you're not going to look very professional. And so I try to use that sort of as a motivator to get you to practice your lettering. So you can find lettering practice sheets. We have one here at Austin Community College called Write Like a Designer PDF. And the theory here is we show you an A, and so you would practice making, you know, like 7 or 8 A's in a row, because really you just need to write them over and over again, because you're really adopting a new way of writing, and you're going to do this on everything you do. You'll always write caps, all capital letters. You'll always print. This will become a part of your lifestyle if you're a professional designer, architect, or engineer. So I hope this helps.